Falconphysics Democast by Steve Dickey from Divine Child High School. To find out more, check the Michigan Learning section of iTunes U, look in the high school section, or go to physics.divinechildhighschool.org.
So yesterday we had to set up on the front table. We had our lab bench with a clamp, and attached to the clamp was some rods, and there was a string and a mass and a string and another mass, and I asked you to find the tension force in each string. Now, I want to think about this a slightly different way, make sure you guys understand what we're talking about. So let's zoom in on one of our masses here, and let's think about how we go about this. How do we figure out what forces are acting on our weight? So the first thing we want to do is we want to draw a picture, which we have here, and then we want to draw an outline around the picture as close to the edges of our object of interest as necessary. Now, why am I circling this even though I asked about the tension in the string? Well, tension is a force applied by the string on this weight. So if I know how much force the string applies to this weight, I know the tension, right? So what I've done is I've outlined our object. This is our system, okay? Now, what goes into our system? That's the question. So are there any objects, first off, crossing our system boundary? In this case, we can see we have a string crossing the system boundary, right? Well, what kind of forces do strings apply? They apply a tension force. So I'm going to go ahead and label my tension force. O-N, right? There we go. Is that how you spell tension? I don't know. Anyway, and then do we have any other forces? Are there any other objects that are crossing our boundary? Well, I don't see any other objects, but there is another interaction that happens across our boundary, right? Because we have the Earth down here, and it can apply a force due to gravity, and that can cross the boundary as well. So we have a gravity force from the Earth. Not so bad, right? So let's free body diagram this. I make my dot. Oh, need my pen tool. Make my dot to represent our object. And now we ask, what forces are acting on our weight? Well, we have two things crossing our system boundary. Therefore, we have two arrows to make, right? We have one down, and this one is the force of gravity by the Earth on our weight, right? Oh, wait, we have two weights, don't we? This is going to get confusing. So let's label this one weight one and this one weight two. That way we won't get confused later. So force of gravity from the Earth acting on weight one. And we can actually calculate the magnitude of that force because we know the mass. The mass of weight one was 1 kilogram. And we know that the Earth applies a force of 10 newtons per 1 kilogram, right? Or 9.8 for those people who want more significant digits. So we know that this force is 10 newtons. Not so bad. Now, the object was just suspended there. So what does that mean? Was it moving? No. Was it accelerating is the more important question, however. And the answer to that is also no. And that means the forces are balanced, which means we need an upward force exactly equal in magnitude to our downward force. Did I draw it right? No, I drew it too long, didn't I? Well, let's fix that. I drew too long. We don't want to have any confusion, so it needs to be the same length as the downward force. All right, there we go. And this is the force of tension from our string on weight one. And I'm going to go ahead and be proactive and realize I have two strings, so I'll label them string one and string two. All right, and I know that this force is 10 newtons. Not so bad, right? So I've got two forces crossing my boundary. I have two arrows representing those forces on weight one. I now know the tension in string one is 10 newtons. Awesome. Now, let's take a look at weight two. Let's draw our system boundary. Sound effects are important. And, you know, it's a dotted line, so it's a dotted sound effect. Alrighty now, let's talk about what we have crossing our system boundary. We have a string. Right? And, string one, this better be string two. So we have string two. It crosses our boundary with a tension force. I'm just going to label it with a T for tension. We have string one crossing our boundary, right? And that's also a tension. And the earth also pulls on weight two, doesn't it? And that's a gravity force. I'm going to put a G for gravity. So how many things are crossing our boundary? Well, we have three, which means our force diagram must have three arrows attached to it. Okay, so how do we make our force diagram? Okay, so I just moved things around a little bit and moved our other force diagram out of the way. All right, so what do we know? We have a dot, right? And I better zoom out once just to make sure we've got plenty of room. I've got our weight two. We know the earth pulls on this with a force we call gravity, right? And so we go whoop, and you see, so we have force of gravity by the earth on weight two. And how big is this force? Well, we're half a kilogram, and if we got half a kilogram and our gravitational strength is 10 newtons per kilogram, we know this force is 5 newtons. Not so bad. Another force pulling down is the tension from string 1. And the force of tension from string 1 on weight 2 we knew was 10 newtons. Pretty cool. Now, weight 2 is not accelerating downward either. It's not accelerating up. It's not accelerating down, left, right, or anything. That means the forces are balanced, which means if I've got 5 newtons plus 10 newtons down, I need to have 15 newtons up, right? So let's count our boxes here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, just over 6 boxes. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There we go. That is a 15-newton arrow up. And we know this is a tension force from string 2 on weight 2. And we know this force is 15 newtons. Not so bad, right? So now if we compare our two force diagrams, we can see that the arrows acting on weight 2 are longer than the arrows acting on weight 1. And if I've drawn them properly to scale, they should be approximately 5 newtons longer. So just to make sure we know what we're talking about, I'm going to put equality marks. We know this is a 10-newton arrow, this is a 10-newton arrow, this is a 10-newton arrow, right? Those are the only equality marks I get to make because this is a 5-newton arrow and this is a 15-newton arrow. Not so bad, right? So again, draw your object, make your system boundary, and then think about the forces that are crossing that boundary. They may be contact forces, as in the case of ours with a string, or they may be non-contact forces, as in the case with gravity.